Honey, I don't know how I survived 4 days by myself.
I know. Hey, nobody hates going on the road more than me. It's miserable for me out there. Hey, look at this. Cal Ripken signed my hat.
Oh, that's great. Look at this. Gregory spit up on my shirt.
I'm not trading.
Okay. Just be happy you made it home for my birthday. That's all I can say.
Oh, what? Of course I made it home for your birthday.
Okay.
Are you kidding? Your birthday is Sunday. That's right. Big party.
And how old am I going to be?
I know that.
Ray? How old?
All right. I just have to backtrack. Let's see. When I proposed, you were 23.
Mm-hmm.
You said no.
Right.
Then I proposed, you were 24.
No again.
Right. Then I took a year off to regroup.
Yep.
Then I came back with a job. Boom, married. That would make you 32-ish.
All right, I'll accept that.
Good, because, big party.
No, you know what? I don't want the party. I just want a nice day at home with my favorite husband and my kids, okay?
Okay. And I guess my parents and my brother, too, right? My parents and my brother? What?
Ray, it's just that, look, you know, I love them. They're my family, too. But I was wondering if perhaps we wouldn't have them over on Sunday.
Well, why not?
Well, it's just, you know, honey, every day that you were gone, they dropped by. And then your dad is always waking up the kids, and now they don't even call first.
Well, they live across the street. Why should they call? It's quicker just to come by.
I know.
It's like we're on the way.
No. We are the way. We are where they're going.
You see, now you're exaggerating a little.
You're home.
Hi, Mom.
Hi. I saw your car pull up before. You didn't call.
No.
Hi, Debra. I brought you some baking soda for your fridge. I smelled something questionable.
From across the street?
No. When I was here yesterday.
Okay.
Ooh, it's worse.
Okay, all right. Ma, we can buy our own baking soda. First.
I know, sweetie, but you don't. Ooh, what have we here? Oh, I'll get you some club soda for that, too.
No, Ma, we have club soda, Ma.
No, your father finished it. I'll see you later.
Oh, it comes from love. Look, if you want, maybe I'll talk to my father about it.
Well, while you're talking to him, would you mind mentioning the answering machine?
Is he playing back the messages again? I changed the code.
Well, he cracked it.
Hope everyone's doing good. And Debra, you ought to call Linda back. She sounds like she had a very interesting visit to the gyno.
That's funny. It's not for everybody, okay? Look, he's fooling around. That's what he does. He's like one of those guys. What do you call him? An idiot.
Well, do we have to bring your brother over?
Well, my brother lives with them. He doesn't like staying alone.
He's 40, Ray.
Come on, he loves the kids.
It's just like the way Robert eats. You know, the way he has to touch every bite to his chin before he puts it in his mouth. It's weird.
What, that's an idiosyncrasy. It's like when he's counting and he gets to the number 12 and he has to take his shoes off.
How did he ever become a police sergeant?
Because he's a good cop, and they didn't make him count. Or eat.
I don't know, Ray. It's just that it's, you know, every day. And between them and the kids, I just feel...
lucky?
Ray!
All right. Look, I'm home now. Maybe you need a break. I'll tell you, why don't you go out with Linda tomorrow night?
What, and leave the kids with your parents?
No, I'll do the kids.
Oh,
I can't do that. Oh, hey, how about the time you went to your aunt's for 3 days?
I took the kids with me.
Yeah, but I fed myself.